Hi, this is Richard Price from CTEK Battery Solutions. Today we're going to be taking a look at the CTEK MUS 4.3 battery charger in the test and charge series. This is a brand new model from CTEK. We've got quite a few inquiries and questions regarding this charger, so we figured we'd make a video show you how to use it. First, we're going to explain what exactly makes this charger different compared to the rest of the CTEK products. And then we're going to go into a few tutorials on how to actually use some of these cool features built into the charger. The 4.3 test and charge will still have the patented 8-step charging cycle that the original 4.3 charger has, but this one has three extra bells and whistles. The first one is going to be an extra battery test, where it's going to test the standing voltage of your battery. The third is going to be a starting test, where you actually hook this charger up to the battery and start your vehicle. It'll actually make sure there's adequate starting power in the battery for your vehicle. And the third and final test will be an alternator test. And what this will show is it'll actually record the voltage output of your alternator and make sure it's adequate enough to charge up your battery. On how it's going to do this is the three LED lights here, and we're actually going to go into a short video series here and show you exactly how these work. Okay, the first thing we're going to do here with the CTEK MUS 4.3 is we're going to go ahead and test out the battery mode. And what the battery mode is going to do is just going to test the preliminary voltage of the battery as it's sitting and just tell you if it's good or bad. What we're going to pay attention to is going to be the three LED lights right here. Red is obviously bad, yellow is going to be fair, and green is going to be good. You always want it to be in the green. So without connecting the power, we're going to go ahead and hook this charger up to our battery. Positive to the positive post, the negative directly on the negative terminal here. Okay, you're going to see the charger blink through the lights. You're going to want to hit the mode button. It'll automatically go into the first setting, which is battery mode. It'll blink a few more times and then land on a solid light. In this case, it's going to be green, so that means that our battery is fully charged. So, the next test here is going to be the start power. And what this does is you're going to hook the battery charger up to the battery and then start the vehicle as quickly as you can. And it's going to test the actual starting power of the battery. So we're going to go ahead and do that right now. So unhook it and hook it back up. And we're going to go ahead and hit the mode button again. It'll switch it over to the start power. And then we're going to start the car. Looks like everything's good on that front. Okay, so we did pass our start test there. The last test we're going to do here is called the alternator test. And what this is going to do is it's going to check the output of the alternator, make sure it's up to par, so that whenever you drain this battery down, every time you start your vehicle, it'll have enough adequate power to charge it back up. So we're going to go ahead and re-hook up the charger to the battery here. And then we're going to go ahead and switch it over to the alternator mode by hitting the mode button one more time. Go ahead and start the car. So start the car. And you see the light starts off in the red. And then it works its way up to the green. And you want to give this test here about 15 seconds. And if the indicator doesn't move, you're actually going to want to rev the car up to about 2,000 RPMs. And that'll give you the most accurate reading possible. Okay, so we've just run you through the three different voltage test programs of the 4.3 test and charge. What we're going to do now here is we're going to hook it up to this North Star battery, and we're going to run it through the different charging combinations and algorithms that you can actually use on this charger. There's going to be a few different options here, so we're going to show you what each one looks like on the LED indicator lamp, and we'll explain what each step does and how it works. Okay, now that we're in the automotive setting here, you're going to see the indicator panel begin to light up there, showing that we are going through the 8-step charging process. Now this particular setting here, the vehicle setting, is going to be used for 12-volt flooded batteries. And if we hit the mode button one more time, that'll bring us into the next phase, what is called the snowflake mode. And in this mode in particular, it's going to be meant for sealed AGM batteries, like Optima, Odyssey, and Northstar. And it's also going to be meant for colder climates. So if you're charging in extremely cold weather, let's say it's winter and you're storing your car long term, you're going to switch it over to the snowflake mode in the automotive series. And the very last mode here is going to be called the recondition mode. And what the recondition mode is meant for is to bring back life into a fully dead battery. So if you had a battery that has been sitting in a vehicle for an extremely long time and it's been completely discharged, chances are sulfation is actually built up inside of the battery. So you'd switch it over to this recondition mode manually, and what that'll do is it'll attempt to bring back and rejuvenate the battery to as much capacity as physically possible. And another nice feature of this charger is that you can do all three modes at the same time. So if you did have a 12-volt automotive battery that was sealed that needed the recondition mode, you can go ahead and select all three, and it'll run through the full 8-step charging process. Now, we only went through the automotive side. There also is, as we discussed earlier, the motorcycle side for the smaller batteries. It'll follow the same charging algorithm that we had just shown you through there.